What is up, guys? Prickix here, back with another video. Today, my initial thoughts on the Kobe 10. I've got three different images, so let's hop right into it. So this first one here, you can see, we see the outsole, and I believe that's the medial side of the left foot. The outsole is like translucent, it's got the X for the 10. Some kind of cushioning in the heel area, looks really nice. Looks like a fuse-based upper. It doesn't look like engineered mesh, it just looks like a regular fuse. You know, nothing really special. And actually, I would have done this video earlier, but I usually wait, because Sneaker News isn't always the first people to get images. But usually I wait for the Sneaker News article to come out, and then I make a video. But like, they haven't done the article at all, so I don't know what's up with that. Maybe they know something that this isn't the Kobe 10, or they just didn't do it. So I just thought I'd put it out anyway. And you know, if this happens, maybe just be a wear test sample or something like that, which it doesn't really look like. You know, it could be whatever. But, you know, that's why I haven't done it earlier. These pictures have been out for a little bit now. And it even looks like we have a, like, zoom air unit in the heel, maybe. I'm not sure. I don't know. You guys can tell me what you think. So let's get into the next image. All right, here's the second picture I have. Technically, it's three pictures in one. But as you can see on the top, we've just got the outsole. Again, it's the same picture we saw. The translucent outsole. There's really nothing different about that. On the bottom left, because the bottom right is essentially the first image, but the bottom left is what's a little different. We've got the heel area. We can see the tongue and the kind of the inside a little bit. But mainly it's the heel cup that we're looking at. And on the right shoe, it's got the Kobe Sudoku logo. And on the left, it's got four stitches. Now, I'm not sure what's so significant about four stitches, because remember, Kobe got nine stitches, and he had nine stitches on the Kobe 9 Elite. So, and the Kobe 9 Low EM. And I'm not sure about the Kobe 9 Elite Low. But on the Kobe 9, he had 9 stitches in the heel. So I'm not sure what's the significance of 4 stitches. The Kobe logo looks kind of cool, but I'm not getting the 4 stitches right now. And obviously there's going to be a story when the shoes are actually unveiled. So we're not getting much more information from this picture. It looks like the same person. We're just getting a little bit of the heel and, you know, the same image that we saw before, the outsole. So now let's get to the very last image. Alright, this image is totally different and a lot more detailed. And this image I actually saw come out on Instagram after the first two images. And I'm pretty sure the first two images, they're calling it the Blue Lagoon colorway. Sounds kind of cool. I'm not sure, obviously names change here and there. But anyway, here you see a breakdown. Basically, it's taken apart from the outsole and all the way into the insole. So starting on the left, the very bit of the outsole, the translucent area. So it looks very thin. I don't know, maybe this won't be good for outdoors. As you can see, so I'm guessing it's a zoom or an air unit in the heel. And then you see we've got like the midsole area. It looks like a zoom. So I'm saying heel zoom. And in the forefoot, I'm not sure if that's Lunarlon. It doesn't really look like Lunarlon. So if it's not and it's just some regular foam, that's going to really suck, because I'd like to have some kind of technology apart from just zoom in the heel. And it even looks like if you look at the towards the toe area near the forefoot, where your forefoot would be, or maybe a little in front of the forefoot, there's a piece of carbon fiber. I'm not exactly sure, it might be TPU, but carbon fiber, and I guess that's for some rigidity. I'm not sure what's the point of that, because that's kind of where you're flexing your foot. I'm not exactly sure what's the point of that. And then we've got the actual upper itself. Now, in this picture, it kind of looks like engineered mesh, but not. To me, it looks like a really flimsy, thin fuse. And it doesn't look like the durability would be too good. That's just my opinion. It looks really flimsy. Doesn't really look like a a durable thing. And then the insole over here is just an insole. We can't tell what it is. I'm not thinking it's Lunarlon. It looks like Ortholite to me. Because if you look around the blue edges, and that's kind of what they do with the Ortholite. So I'm not sure. You guys tell me your thoughts on the Kobe 10 in the comments below. I'm not sure if this is Kobe 10. It might be. We don't know. Rare Kicks, signing off.